finally, after years of waiting, I got my complete collector's edition Kickstarter of Everdell. And I thought this might be a really fun video. So I didn't bother to put on anything swanky. I didn't bother to go around and try to find my clip-on mic. I just set a box on my desk and I thought to myself, let's pull everything out together and let's admire the artwork, because that's what I love to do. So let's get started. Now I have moved the giant box so that it's beside me and you can actually see me. And let's start pulling stuff out of the box. If you haven't played it, Everdell is one of my absolute favorite games. And my gosh, it's a giant box. I will also say, because I am a nice sister, that I also got for my brother and my sister-in-law, I added some stuff to my Kickstarter for them, so I have duplicates of some things in here, but I don't think that's a big deal. I'm gonna need every ounce of effort in my body to get this giant box out of this box, so two ticks. Expansion, and honestly I just skipped some of the rules in that one because I feel like they're not entirely necessary. So, original game, what I got, just for reference, show you the sheer mass of this box. It's very heavy. Let's open her up. One of the things I love about having long fingernails is I can very easily get into products. No need for a knife. I've got nails. First, because it's beautiful. So the thing I really love with Everdell, and the reason that I wanted to show it off a little bit today, is honestly the artwork. It is an amazing game, but it's even better because it's so stinking cute, isn't it? I mean, look at them. They're adorable little animals. Look at them. And this is something that I've loved with a lot of newer games, is that they really spend a lot of time on the artwork, and it makes the whole game experience way more fun. Because now it's not just you're looking at game mechanics, you're trying to figure out all the rules of play, you're also being like, look at the adorable little things that they hid in the artwork. Look at all these cute things that I can find in here. And they also do this really fun thing where they make most most of the box is usually flat, and then the rest of it they'll do like a shiny glaze over the top. Let me stand this up again and I will show you. Do you have a little bit of damage up here from? Hi. So at this point it's been about a week. Yeah, about a week since I got my copy of Everdell the Complete Collection, and I just wanted to talk about it for a sec because in the video I really tried to play down how upset I was that the box is broken, and I think I actually did a pretty good job. And I think a lot of that was due to the fact that I didn't look at it very closely when I was first recording. But the box is broken. The box is broken pretty badly. To the point that it's difficult to get the card sleeve portion, like the card sleeve container, out of the box at all. Because like I show you that the corner of the box is torn, and that whole corner is like dented in so that everything that like puzzles perfectly into that box doesn't come out easily. So I did my original recording on a Saturday. On that same day I emailed Tabletop Tycoon, that are the ones that did the Kickstarter, to let them know that my box was broken. And I am doing this little update in the middle of my Everdell video to tell you that their customer service was so bad that I've decided to record this and tell you to be wary of Kickstarter, I guess. I have had terrible experiences both times that I've done Kickstarter games. This is the worst. My box is broken. I sent them pictures and their response was a email macro, clearly. I work in logistics, I know what a macro looks like, that said they were sorry to hear about the damage to my box and that they would be dealing with damages in the coming weeks and that they would let me know if they needed anything else from me in the meantime. They did not say if they would be making this right. They did not say any time frame in which this would be dealt with. All they've said is that I have to wait potentially months, I believe until they're done with fulfillment, before they will figure out what to do about my damaged box. I also want to say that I did look at the box that my copy of the Everdell Complete Collection came in, and it is not damaged. The damage that was made to my complete collection was done before it was shipped to me. It had happened in warehouse, and it really feels like the company does not care, and they have, for some reason, no interest in making this right. I've gone on the Kickstarter page and left them a comment to tell them how disgruntled I am. I did reply to their email on Monday, and it is now Thursday as I'm recording this, and they have not replied at all. I have been very kind in things that I've replied to them with to let them know that it is not acceptable to not tell your customer if you're even going to make the situation right. Yeah, I am very disappointed. I am basically storing this company's damaged goods for the foreseeable future. And if I didn't love Everdell so much, I would just send the whole thing back and tell them that they owe me my money back. But I legitimately love this game and I just wanted to have the complete collection,
I've put hundreds of dollars into this and they don't care. So I am peeved. I am at this point probably what you would consider disgruntled. And I will let you guys know probably on Instagram if the situation ever gets resolved. Because at this point, I don't know if it will be. But I can't play Everdell. I can play the original, but I can't play the new ones because they won't fix the problem. And I don't want to open more of the packaging and then have them claim that it was me that broke it because all of the stuff is open. So, fortunately, I have me opening it on video because I'm showing it to you guys. So I have video evidence of when I found the tear in the box. And yeah, I don't know if that'll help my case, but yeah. Anyway, I'll let you guys get back to watching the unboxing. I think I did actually really good job of not showing how upset I was at the time, so you might not see it at all, but I am very upset. I waited, I think, almost 2 extra years to get this box, and to have it come damaged and to have the company basically blow me off was just that it doesn't feel good. Mm-mm. It doesn't feel good at all. And I won't be using Kickstarter again anytime. No. I'll just wait till the game hits the shelves. Highly recommend it. Just wait till it hits the shelves. Anyway, enjoy the rest of the video. The complete collection looks great, and hopefully soon I will have my own not damaged version of the game so I can actually play it. In the meantime, my friend also got it and his is fine, so I guess I'll play his. Enjoy the rest of the video, guys, and thank you for listening to my mid-video rant. And the whole point of Everdell is that you're building a town, and they keep adding things to make it more difficult or just more interesting to add things to your town. And I guess this added 2 expansions and just a bunch of really fun little features. So I'm super stoked to see what all is in here because honestly, it's been so long since the Kickstarter that I don't remember all that's in here. I do know that I'm still gonna need to get Belfair and Pearlbrook because I don't have those. My brother and sister do, so I didn't bother to buy those yet, but I will get those at some point, and I believe this box is supposed to fit everything from all of the expansions and the base game. Store everything. That's really nice. That's really, really nice. I did a video on it when I got it, which was years ago. It was, oof, I don't know when it was at this point. But I got the Kickstarter for the Terraforming Mars big box, and they did not tell you where to put any of the components inside the box. It was super frustrating. But no, this tells you where you're supposed to store everything inside your big box.
And then on the back, they have the assembly instructions for the Evertree and for the Wonders. And those are from Pearl Brook, so I don't have those. I don't know if this came with them. I don't think it did. So these are some of the things from the base game. These are the monies. These are from Pearl Brook. These are from Spirecrest. And these little webs are new, so I don't really know what those are for yet. Oh, it actually looks like it has all of this stuff from Pearl Brook, because these are the wonders that are only in Pearl Brook. Those were the things I was just saying I didn't have. These are little open signs. There are some cards in the game, if you haven't played before, that other characters can go to. They're like action things that you have in your town. And if there are things other players can go to, you're supposed to put a little open sign by them. And these are little axolotls. I don't remember what they do. What is this? Oh, this is from Belfair. This is a market. I've only played Belfair once, so that's all I really know, is that it's from Belfair. These are tickets for one of the other expansions. So I can find out what it's called. I don't know. Cute. I don't know what these do. I'm gonna have to read through the rules. Let's see what they've got. Oh yeah. Everdell is also a video game now. I have it on Steam. I love it. I've played Wingspan on this channel. Wingspan is really hard as a computer game. The way that they did Everdell makes so much more sense. It is so easy. You can see the entire board even though it's huge. I don't get confused. So much easier to see what you're doing, understand what you're looking at, and just the gameplay is still super, super fun. Okay. So this holds this stuff from Pearl Brook. It's blue and it's got the little Pearl Brook frog on it, embossed. Some seaweed and little pearls and stuff. Fishy. It's super cute. This is a tray. This is the thing that's being noisy. This holds the Evertree and all of the critters, which we'll open up in a few so that we can see what all of them look like. I think there's new critters. There's a piece of cardboard. We'll set off to the side. Ooh, I like that crinkle. That's a nice crinkle. This is Everdell, the Gilded Book Comprehensive Rules. We'll look through that in a minute here too. Let's see what I can actually pull out of here next. This, I think I should be able to tip without being too noisy. Has the single player dice, has all of the resin and pearls and berries and pebbles and twigs and money and everything, and this is where you store all of those. And I think this also fits the deluxe vessels, which I got and didn't show you. This set here. So So we have, let's see if I can get it to stop glaring. I have two acorns for the occupied tokens. I have a basket for berries, things for special event cards, a minecart for the pebbles, a shell for the pearls, a stump for the resin, a twig barge for the twigs, and walnuts for point tokens. That's so cute. We will open that up in a little bit as well and check those out. Let's see. Is this the bottom? This is the bottom. This down here is a tray that holds the game boards, the Nightweave and player boards, Pearlbrook overlays, market board score pad, and a cloth bag that I have no idea what that's for. Over here, what is this? I forgot about this. Oh my goodness, I forgot about this. These are stickers that you place on the various wood tokens so that they now have like a little bit more character to them. We will open that up and look through those as well. This box contains the card area and then small tokens go in here as well. So I think like the path things for it's right here, Spire Crest, and little things like that will go in this. And then last but not least, down here is that thing I was telling you about that has the player boards and the, this I think is more occupied tokens, that cloth bag. And then that's the rest of the boards for the game. This is nice. Okay. So let's start from the bottom up. And we will open things up and we'll put things away. Sound like a plan? Okay. So, beginning with that last tray I showed you. So this is from Belfair, which again, I've only played once, so I don't really know what's going on with that. This is the base game. You can see how it gets huge. The Evertree goes up here. Belfair, I think, actually ends up sitting right here. And then Pearlbrook goes on that side. Something goes over here, and Spire Crest goes down here. This one's for Spire Crest. You can see it fits into that bottom portion of that piece I just showed you. And this is the path you go along. This one is Pearlbrook. So maybe I don't need to get the expansions. Maybe this just has everything. If it does, I'll just give Spirecrest to my brother. This is new. This is that train. Which must go on the other side of the board, I don't know. Interesting. I will have to look through the rules for that. Okay, how did this come out of here? They do very clearly have a specific way that they go in. I was not making note of that when I was taking them out. So, darn. That actually looks right. Okay. Okay. purses go with Belfair, and I think this is just to like help organize your city. I think. Again, I've only played that one once, so I don't really remember. But these all look like that's what they're for. Ooh, what is this? What is this? This is for Nightwave. This is for the spider thing. Interesting. I don't know what any of these things mean. They're spiders. I'll have to look into that as well. Here. Oh, these are stickers. These are stickers for occupied tokens. Oh, that's nice. It came with a score pad. That's one of the things that I had a hard time with for the base game, because I really wanted there to be a score pad. And then there isn't one, and it was just... it's a little hard to keep track of everything at the end of the game. And it's one of those where playing online is really nice because you don't have to keep track of all of your scoring stuff. This is the next thing. And I don't know if this is meant to come out of here or not. So I'm not going to pull it out. I don't actually know if I'm going to go through all of these right now. These look like they're for the base game. This also looks like it might be for the base game. These are base game cards. And these just say complete collection, and I think this is all of the collector's edition stuff. Again, not positive on that. If there's one thing that I don't like with getting stuff from Kickstarter, it's that you can't always tell exactly what you're getting, and they were not super clear on what came with everything. So I'm just kind of like, I don't know what's in this box. Stuff. Silica, I have lots. Actually, I have a really good use for silica. I put it in my shoeboxes. Keeps the stink away. Down to this guy that is just the Evertree and all of the player tokens. And what I really want to get to here is the player tokens, because the Evertree, honestly, I will probably assemble it and put it somewhere in my house. Critters too. Look at this spider. New big critters. These are from Spire Crest. don't know what all of these critters are. There's a snail. More silica. The original big critters. This is my favorite. I always play the foxes. And they're great because you can line them up and they kind of look like they're in a conga line. I know I'm silly. What is this? I think this might be like a stoat or something. He's very cute. Axolotls. Little owls. There's little owls, guys. Legit, I don't remember what's in here. More spiders. Snails, butterflies, hedgehogs, little, like a cardinal or something. Bats? That's so cute. These are adorable. Okay, okay. Let me open up the sticker pack and we're gonna take a look at that, and that will tell us what all the critters are, and I will sticker them some other time because I don't think I have the patience for this today. Alright, so let's look at these sticker packs and see what animals we have. We have mice, hedgehogs and squirrels, and more mice, rats. Not sure what he is. He might be a rat. These guys. Those are from the original game. There's a platypus. Okay. Turtles, platypi, birds. That's gotta be like a stoat or something. We have cardinals, axolotls, little froggies, the spiders. We've got my favorite, the foxes. We have what might be some kind of a mole, and the owls, and more of the spiders at the bottom. We have lizards, snails, and cats, and then butterflies. We have a little bee, bats, and more butterflies. Oh no, this is definitely a stoat, so I don't know what that other one was. Some kind of a weasel. And I think this is a pig. And then we have the rabbits from Spire Crest. More rabbits, more rabbits. More rabbits. And the frogs from Pearlbrook. More froggies. More froggies. These are the big critters from Spirecrest. These are the rest of the big critters and the spiders. And now I'm wondering if I'm supposed to have two spiders. I definitely only have one big spider, but I have enough stickers for two. Maybe it was a space thing? I don't know. We'll see if there's like a contents thing somewhere. The other things that I have are the comprehensive Everdell rules, which is just all of the rules for New Leaf and Mistwood and Spirecrest. That's all the expansions. Rugwort. These are all the original stuff. This is the contents of the complete collection. So that's really nice. That'll tell me what I need to get. Look at all of that. only one spider. Big spider, anyway. Oh, this tells me what all the critters are. Okay. There's a cardinal, a fox, a cat, a bee, a lizard, a toad, a turtle, a starling, butterfly, spider, platypus, snail, pig, axolotl, owl, stoat, and otter, bat, squirrel, and mole, hedgehog, rat, and mouse. Oh, cute. And then we've got some new big critters that have official names. I've got all of the stuff that goes in here, and then we go into setup and gameplay. And if you haven't played this before, please do. It's so much fun. The archive, what is this? Oh, icon references, information on critter cards, information on construction cards, special events, basic events, forest cards. Okay, so this is like the index. That's really nice that it's separate, because sometimes while you're playing the game, you need to be looking at the rules, but looking at this at the same time. So that's really nice. I really like that. I am so happy with my purchase, and I'm so happy it's finally here. As you can see, they've got a ton of really cute artwork. I mean, these stickers are going to add so much to the game. I'm actually pretty good at getting stickers on straight, so I'm not concerned about the stickering. It is probably something that I will do later on, and I will most likely post pictures on Instagram when I get that done. So if you're not following me on Instagram, go over there and do that. I am also trying to do reels now of some of my latest paintings. As you can see, I'm in my office today, so yeah. I will hopefully be recording more in here from now on. It is still a bit of a challenge figuring everything out, but thank you guys so much for your patience. Thank you for watching this quick little My Kickstarter is Finally Here video, and I will see you guys next time. Have a good one. Bye!